Dear aspirants, I'm back. Welcome you all in Militarying channel. In previous videos, I have talked about Kashmir War of 1947 and Indochina War of 1962. In this video, we will move further by talking about Indo-Pak War of 1965. With the continuation of war series which India has fought with its neighboring nation. Since the partition of British India in 1947, Pakistan and India remained in contention over several issues. Although the Kashmir conflicts was the predominant issue dividing the nations, other border disputes existed, most notably over the run of Kutch, a barren region in the Indian state of Gujarat. The verdict, which came later in 1962, saw Pakistan awarded 350 square miles of the run of Kutch, as against its original claim of 3,500 square miles. After its success in run of Kutch, Pakistan under the leadership of General Ayub Khan believed the Indian Army would be unable to defend itself against a quick military campaign in the disputed territory of Kashmir. As the Indian military had suffered a loss to China in 1962, in the Sino-Indian War, Pakistan believed that the population of Kashmir was generally discontented with Indian rule and that a resistance movement could be ignited by a few infiltrating saboteurs. Pakistan attempted to ignite the resistance movement by means of a covert infiltration, condemned Operation Gibraltar. The Pakistani infiltrators were soon discovered, however, their presence reported by local Kashmiris, and the operation ended unsuccessfully. The Indo-Pak War of 1965 was the second conflict between India and Pakistan. The war took place after Pakistani launched a covert operation across the ceasefire line in India-occupied Kashmir, a fact that Pakistan continues to dispute to this day. The 17-day war caused thousands of casualties on both sides and also witnessed the largest tank battle since World War II. Under 28 Indian tanks and 150 Pakistani tanks were destroyed. At the beginning of the war, the Pakistani army had both a numerical advantage in tanks as well as better equipment overall. Pakistani armor was largely American-made, equipped with 19mm guns. However, recent documents released by the Indian government confirmed that India had successfully captured the Hajipir Pass, which was one of the main places under dispute from Pakistan. The war remains controversial because, unlike the other wars, the Pakistan army never really signed a surrender document. Both India and Pakistan claimed victory. However, most neutral assessments agree that India had the upper hand over Pakistan when ceasefire was declared. Unlike wars since, this time the Indian army made deep inroads inside Pakistan and destroyed several weapons and vehicles integral to the Pakistan army. Close to 1,000 tanks on both sides took part in pitched battles and offensives. At the start of the war, India had one armoured division and one independent armoured brigade. Along with 6 armoured regiments supporting infantry divisions, Pakistan had 2 armoured divisions equipped with the then very modern M48 Patton tanks. India had an equivalent tank in the Centurion, but their strength was limited to only 4 armoured regiments. The battle was so fierce and intense that at the end of the war, the 4th Indian Division, the Fighting 4th, had captured about 97 tanks in destroyed, damaged or intact condition. Around 15 of them were captured by Pakistan Army. Such was the might of the Indian Army that it managed to push back the Pakistan Army into Lahore and even hoisted the Indian flag in the Lahore sector before it walked back victorious. After Pakistan troops invaded Kashmir, India moved quickly to internationalize the regional dispute. It asked the United Nations to reprise its role in the first Indian-Pakistan war and end the current conflict. The Security Council passed Resolution 211 on September 20, calling for an end to the fighting and negotiation on the settlement of the Kashmir problem. The United States and the United Kingdom supported the United Nations decision by cutting off arms supplies to both belligerents. This ban affected both belligerents, but Pakistan felt the effect more keenly since it had a much weaker military in comparison to India. The United Nations resolution and the halting of arms sales had an immediate impact. India accepted the ceasefire on September 21 and Pakistan on September 22. After the war, Lieutenant General Joginder Singh Dhillon was awarded with Padma Bhushan in 1966 by the Government of India. He became the first Indian Army officer to receive Padma Bhushan. And highest gallantry award, Paramveer Chakra was awarded to the Company Quartermaster Hawaldar Abdul Hamid posthumously, and to Lieutenant Colonel Ardeshir Burjorji Darapur posthumously. With this year, we came to an end of today's topic, the Indo-Pak War of 1965. So dear aspirant, if you like the videos, please subscribe my channel Military Inc. and press the bell icon for further updates. Thank you.